You know, if you go back to 7, 8, or 9, we saw the financial meltdown that brought everything. Then we saw a housing, residential housing meltdown. People now are talking about the auto industry slowing down, commercial real estate slowing down as a result of Amazon, a lot of retail malls, et cetera, you know, having to close. What are the two or three indices you're looking at that would support kind of the information, as Maria said, that came out of your survey?
Sure. Well, I don't think, first of all, the economists are basing their forecast, let's say, for next year on anything that's happening at this very moment. So what I would always be watching, of course, the housing market, as you referenced, although we also know that typically the future crisis is not going to be just like the crisis that we had last time around, and thank goodness for that. But I would continue to watch consumer confidence. Obviously, that's very strong, retail sales strong, and business confidence. And I think, if anything, we just saw with the ISM manufacturing survey yesterday, we do continue to get a pretty strong body of commentary, whether it's ISM, the Fed base.
I'm not going to even let him finish because this is all just garbage. So what he's talking about, the beginning, he's right. So if interest rates go up, that means your car loans, the cost of getting a car loan is going up. And that's going to cause a lot of people to default. And then the same with real estate. The cost of real estate is going up with interest rate. That's also going to create a lot of defaults, especially people buying at bubble prices on adjustable arms, which is something that happened. So the problem we have here is that our debt hasn't been going down. We had high levels of debt in 2008, stock market collapses, debt levels go down because of that. So that's great. And then guess what happens after 3-4 years out of the recovery, our debt levels have been going back up. And now we are actually at higher debt levels than in 2008. And guess what? Interest is going to go up. The cost of borrowing is going to go up. And that's the main reason why debt skyrocketed, is because it was so cheap to borrow debt. And you know, it would be foolish for you not to, you know, for example, I'm not paying off my real estate loans because I have 30-year fixed loans. It's, you know, 3% is free money. I'm not going to pay off that debt. But now, all of a sudden, if my rate goes up to 4%, 5%, 6%, not only are my payments now really, really high, but I got to try to pay that off. And that's going to be a problem if my taxes are going up because, you know, our tax cuts were front-loaded and wages haven't gone up. And what's even more interesting is you have someone like Amazon just dominating a market and basically, unfortunately, destroying a lot of higher paying jobs. And let me know your thoughts on this. How it relates to crypto is the crypto market will stay down and will be dead as long as the stock market looks like a good investment and the bond market looks like a decent investment. But eventually it's going to, in real estate market, eventually it's going to flip. And that's when we're going to get our next bull run for cryptocurrency. So it's just being patient and being disciplined to continue to buy these dips if it does dip more in cryptocurrency, and then also not cashing out too soon when the bull market for cryptos come out. But let me know your thoughts on this, and I will talk to you guys soon.